Hello and welcome to day 5 of the Halloween Craft Countdown, where I'm releasing a new Cricut craft every day for the whole of October. Today we are making these greetings cards. So these are really cute, they're made with acetate, so the front of the card has this see-through window behind it and you've got your design on the front and the back. And you've then got an insert which, when the card is closed, gives a lovely burst of colour. And when it's opened, it means you've got the colour inside and then it opens up to reveal your message, which you can write on the panel. So first I'm going to show you how to create your own designs in Design Space. So you could put whatever Halloween graphics you want on your card. It doesn't have to be the tree and the ghost. You don't even have to use this technique for Halloween. It would work well for birthday cards, Christmas cards, or anything you can think of. So let's jump into Design Space and get cracking with designing our card. I've opened up Design Space and chosen some images to use. I've made all of my images black by clicking on them and going into the colour box at the top and selecting black, just because it'll be easier for us to create our scene on the front of the card if all the images are the right colour. Now you'll notice that I've chosen quite simple images, so they're only one layer each and they're all one colour. I need to create the card base, which will form the final card that I'm going to be making. So I'm going to do this as a rectangle with a score line down the middle so that you can fold the piece in half to create your card base. I'm going to go into shapes and choose a square. I need to click the little padlock icon so that I can turn it into a rectangle, and then at the top you want to change the width to double the width of a card you want to make. So I want to make a 5-inch square card, so my width needs to be 10, which is double 5, and then my height will be 5. So this is going to be my card base, and I want to score a line right down the middle to make it easier to fold. If you don't have a scoring tool, then you can miss this step out. But if you do, it's always easier when you're folding if you do have a score line, and it means you'll get it directly in the middle. So I would recommend doing this step if you have a scoring tool. I'm just going to change the colour of this to white so I can see the outline. Go into shapes and choose score line. I'm just going to drag this vaguely into position, and then in the height box at the top, change it to 5, which is the same as the height of my card. I want this score line to be exactly in the middle, so if you click and draw a box around the outside of the card layer and the score line, then go into align and then center, that will perfectly center that score line in the middle of the overall card shape. So now we have that perfectly at that 5-inch mark along the width. At this point, I'm just going to select those two layers by dragging around them and then right click and duplicate. And this duplicated one will be the insert for our card. So I can go ahead and change the color of this rectangle to blue, which is going to be the color I'll use for the insert. And then select the blue layer and that score line and go down to the bottom of your layers panel and press attach. And then we can just put this to one side for now and we'll think about it later. But let's move back on to the card front. So as this is going to be a window card, we need to cut a window out of this square. Go into shapes again and choose another square and make it the size of your card front. So mine will be 5 by 5 inches. And then I'm gonna position it over this one. Select this layer and then press Control on your keyboard and choose the white rectangle we've already got. And then go into Align and choose, where is it? Align right, and then go in again and press Align top. And that was kind of hard to see as I managed to line them up quite well by eye. But what that's done is it's put this grey square exactly along the top and the right of the white square, which means this is acting as the front of our card. And now it'll all be lined up, ready for us to choose a new square and set it to the size of the window we want to cut out. So I'm going to go for 4 inches. And just make this a bright colour so it's easier to see. I think 4 might be a little bit small, so maybe 4.5. Okay, We need to put this directly in the middle of the grey square, so choose the yellow square in your layers, press Ctrl on your keyboard and then choose the grey one, go into Align and then Center. And that's moved the yellow square, so now it's exactly in the middle of this grey one. So now we're going to start slicing this yellow square out to create our cutouts. First, select the yellow square, press Ctrl on your keyboard and choose the grey one. And then down the bottom of the Layers panel, click on the Slice tool. We've now got three different slice results. So I've got the yellow square, then a grey square, and I don't need that one. So I'm going to click the eye, and then I have the grey outline. I need to do the slicing again, but this time on the white rectangle. So click on your yellow layer, press Ctrl on your keyboard, and then find your white rectangle, and again, press Slice. Now we can hide that yellow square and the white one underneath, and this has just left us with the outline. And then we've also got, if I hide that, we've also got this shape as well. So here we go. Now we've lost our score line on our rectangle, and that's because when you slice things, Design Space moves the layer to the top. So I'm just gonna click and drag it below the score line again. And now that score line is there, and I'm just gonna double check it's still in the right place. So with both of those layers selected, go into Align and Center. You see it did kind of get out of kilter a bit. So now that's perfectly in the middle again, I can go ahead and click Attach. And that is my main card base done. So once you fold it, you'll have the back of the card, and then the front will have this cutout window in it. This one that we made here, this square, this is going to be where we're going to build up the decorations. So we're going to add all the images in front of here. We're going to need one more square, and that's the one which we'll cut out with acetate. So go into Shapes again and choose a square and make this the same width as your card front. So mine is 5 by 5 inches. I'm just going to make it a nice red color so I remember it's there, and then place that off to one side. Okay, so let's neaten this up a bit in our layers. So all of these slice results that we've hidden, we can just go in and delete. I just find it easier to delete things that you're not going to need so that they don't get in your way later. I'm also going to click the little arrows on the left of our attached parts just to kind of hide the layers and make it easier to see all the picture ones we've got underneath. So let's have a recap of what we've made so far. We've got the card front, which is this white rectangle. We've got the insert, which is over here, and I'm going to make that a little tiny bit smaller in a little while. Actually, I might do it now just whilst I'm here. So the height I've got at the moment is 5 inches. I'm just going to change it to 4.75. So that's just such a tiny bit smaller, just a quarter of an inch, but it means when I fold it, it'll be easier to fit inside the card if it's a teeny weeny bit smaller than the card front, and it means you're not going to have bits of blue overlapping the edge. You don't want to make it any smaller than a quarter of an inch in total, because otherwise it'll be too small that you'll see the edges underneath your cutout on the front. And you'll see when I assemble my card later on in this video that the first time I made this, I did actually make my insert too small. So that's why I'm saying now, this is a little bit of a re-record after I did my test. Only resize it to just 4.75, so just take off a quarter of an inch. When I did it the first time, I took off a lot more and it ended up too small, as you'll see later. So learn from my mistakes and just set that teeny weeny bit smaller. So yeah, 4.75. All right, so we've also created a 5-inch square, which is this red one, which will be cut out of acetate. And that will sit in between the layers of the card to give it some stability. Finally, we have this 5 by 5 inch square with a big gap in the middle, and that is what we're going to be using next to build up our Halloween scene. So I'm going to zoom in so you can see a bit easier, and actually I'm going to move that out the way. And then zoom in. And now that's a bit easier to see. Okay, so this square, I'm going to change the color to black so that it matches all of the black pictures. I'm going to need to make all my pictures smaller to get them to fit. But now is the fun part, because you can start dragging all your images over and getting them inside the square. Now, if your square layer is above all the images in your layers panel, like mine is, it's quite hard to do because every time you try and click, it'll grab that square instead of the picture. So I'm just going to move my square all the way to the bottom by clicking and dragging. And now I can choose the images, and that's all a bit easier. Okay, so let's build up this design. I'm going to start with the tree. And the key to this is you want to make sure that all of your images are connected and touching the edge in at least one place. And the reason we do that is that if they're not touching the edge, then everything's just going to fall apart when you try and cut it out, because there won't be anything joining it together. So you see, I'm moving this tree so it's big enough that it's touching the bottom, the right-hand side of my card, and the top. Now, don't worry if bits of it go over the edge, like on the right-hand side here. We'll fix that right at the end once we've positioned everything on the card. So, what else have I got? I've got this cat, and I think I'll put that next to the tree. So again, the feet are touching the line at the bottom and the tail is going to be touching the tree. So that cat is nicely connected to things that I've already put in the design. So let's have a little look at what else I've got. I thought it'd be nice to have a bit of a decorative corner, which is why I chose this image. So let's just put that in there. And then I'm going to move my ghost. I think he needs to be a bit bigger. So again, I'm connecting him to the tree and also to the ornate bit on the edge. So there we go. He's nice and connected. You know what? I think I want my tree to be a bit bigger, because these edges are going to be quite difficult to cut as they're so thin. And by making the tree bigger, it means it can connect to the ghost in a few more places. Again, don't worry about it poking out the top. We'll fix that at the end. And likewise, if you get any really tiny little gaps, so for example, if I zoom in, you can see we've got this little gap between the tree and the ghost, and then there's a few tiny gaps in other places. We'll fix those all at the end once we've got all the other images into position. So let's see what else I have. And you don't need to use these same images. You can choose whatever images you want. So you can make any kind of Halloween scene. Or in fact, it doesn't even have to be Halloween. You could do this same technique for any type of card. So a birthday card or Christmas or whatever it is that you want to make. So my little pumpkin, he is connected on this right side, the bottom, and then he's connected to the tree too. And then I think I've just got two pumpkins left. Yeah, there we are. So let's make these a bit smaller. And then put these, I think, in this corner, because we've got quite a lot of empty space. Right, there we are. So that's my scene. So, I mean, I did do this quite quickly. You probably want to take some more time and get it looking a little bit neater. But generally, I am happy with how this is looking. I'm going to drag a box around all of these layers, and then in the layers panel at the top, press group. This has grouped all of these together, which means that if you hide it, it hides them all. So it's going to be easier to work with. We need to start fixing all of the bits of the pictures that are going outside of the edges. But before we do that, I'm going to right click on the group and press duplicate to make a copy, and then close the group by pressing the little arrows and click on the eye icon to hide it. And that just means if I need to, I've got a copy of this with all of the layers separate. So if I need to go back in the future and make changes, it's just easier now that I've got a copy of that group. But for the group I've already got, I'm just going to click on it and ungroup it again by pressing ungroup. Go down to the square and then right click and duplicate that. And then I just want to position this in the same position as the other one. So to make it easier, choose one layer, press Control on your keyboard and choose the original one. Go into Align and then Center. And the reason for that will become clear in a minute when we start welding things out. So I'm just going to hide that duplicated one. And now I'm going to select all my pictures and that original slice result. Go down to the bottom and press weld. All right, so what weld does is it merges all of your layers into one. So now you can see you've got this weld result in the layers panel, and all of my pictures is now one layer. We can go ahead and start erasing all of these bits around the outside of the rectangle, square, thing. So go into shapes and choose a square and make it a nice bright color so it's easy to see. Click on the padlock icon on the bottom left and then drag it out so it's a rectangle shape. And then we want to position it so that it's about halfway into the border line, the black border along the top, and that it covers any bits you had coming over the top with the orange. And then right click on the orange layer and duplicate it, rotate it round, and you can press shift to rotate it evenly, and do the same on any other side that you've got bits coming out of the design. So I don't need to do mine along the bottom as I don't have any bits sticking out there. Select all of your orange rectangles or whatever color it is you've made them and press weld. Now select the orange layer and then press Control on your keyboard and choose the layer with all your pictures, so your black layer. Go down the bottom and press slice. This is going to cut the pieces apart. So if I just go through and delete these slice results, you can see I've been left with this, which has got rid of all of the edges, but it's also cut into my border. And that's why we did a copy of the border earlier. So when I turn that back on, you can see it's going to fill that outline back in. So now I can choose both of those layers and weld them together. Interesting. That is very strange. Okay, let's undo that. If when you're welding, things do end up getting stuck together like that, a way you can fix it is to zoom out a lot. So I can get these two layers. So I've zoomed out loads. I'm going to select these two layers and make them really big. And then try welding again. Okay, so you see it's still done it, so that's fine. I can undo. But one final trick I can try is this slice result, which is just the square. I'm going to drag it above my main picture, select them both again and try welding. And that time it's worked. So it's just a weird design space quirk that sometimes things weld a bit funny. So now I need to make sure I change this back to the right size, which is 5 inches. So just type 5 in there and then I can zoom back in to see how that's looking. Okay, so I think when I welded this the first time, that's probably when I lost this ghost's eye. So I'm just going to give him a little circle for his other eye. I know it's not quite right, but it'll do for now because I don't want to have to redo the whole thing. So let's slice that and then delete. Okay, there we go. A little temporary eye for my ghostie. All right, so this is getting there. It's nearly ready, but what we need to do now is just try and find any teeny tiny cut lines on this, which are going to be problematic. So, for example, you've got a tiny space in these branches. So I've got this small area between the branches at the top, and also there's this tiny gap next to the ghost, and there are a few more that my Cricut's just going to struggle to cut these out. So I want to fill in these tiny gaps. To do that, click on the layer and go into contour. It will take a little while to load, but when it does, you can just go in and click all of the teeny tiny gaps. Nope, that was a big one. So if you click one by mistake that you think is small, but it's actually connected to something else, just click it again and it will come back on. But all of the teeny tiny spaces, I'm just going to go in and click to remove them. And the more you do this, the easier it'll be for your Cricut machine to cut out the design, especially if you're using the same tree that I've used, because this is very fiddly with all the little branches, so I want to make it as easy as possible for my Cricut. So I'm just taking out some of these gaps, having a look. There aren't as many as I thought there were going to be, so that's good. That one's quite small. Okay, I think that is all of them that I need to do. But you can close out of it and just have a look on your main design. And if you spot any more, just click into contour again and go to fill them out. So these lines at the top, they're quite small, but I think that's the one that was actually joined to the big one, yeah. So if there are little bits you want to take out, but they're connected to a big bit, so you can see this is filling in this big gap on the left. What you can do is go into shapes and choose a square, make it black, and then resize it and turn it into a rectangle, and just cover over the gap you want to fill in. So mine is this one at the top, and then select that and your main layer and just weld them together. And now that's filled in that little gap that the contour button wasn't letting me fill. Okay, so let's zoom out. Here we go. And this is now almost ready to start cutting. Woohoo! All right, so let's bring all the other layers back in. So we've got our insert here. We've got the acetate square, which I'll just put under there for now, and the card front. But we need one more thing, and that is a copy of our picture square, but flipped the other way around. And that's because when we build the card up, we're gonna need one to go on the front, and then one to go on the inside to cover where the acetate has been glued on, because we don't want to open the card and see all of the glue, as that will just look messy. So to do that, click on your picture layer and then right click on it and press duplicate. So let's drag it down here, and then we need to flip it. So go into flip and press flip horizontal, and that will move it to the other way around. And now this is all ready for me to go and click make it and cut out with my Cricut machine. So I'll go ahead and do that and then jump in to show you how to stick it all together. So here are my pieces cut out, and I'm going to start with the main card front and fold it in along the score line. This is a little bit fiddly because there's not a lot of space after the score line, so it will try and fold in the wrong place. But just persevere and try and get it flat along that score line. So just go down it and be really gentle and careful and get it folded nice and crisp. Press it down to make sure you've got a good fold, and then that is the main part of our card ready. I'm going to stick the acetate to the inside of the card. You could also do it on the outside, it's up to you. I think the outside might actually stick a little bit easier, but I didn't think of that when I was doing this, so I did it on the inside. So it is up to you which way round you want to stick it. So take some glue, or you could use double-sided tape, and just put some all the way around the edge. You want to make sure you go down all four sides to get a good stick all the way around the square. Take your acetate and make sure you don't get any glue on the inside of the card, but stick your acetate to the back where you've just put all of the glue. Line it up carefully so that it doesn't overlap any of the edges, and then push it down to make sure it's going to stick to that glue nicely. I'm going to close my card up just to make sure I've not put it too far over, that it's gone over the crease down the middle, but that appears to be fine, so I can set it to one side so that it can dry. Whilst that's drying, I'll prepare the insert. So fold your insert paper in half down the score line. Make sure you've got a nice crisp fold. I noticed that my acetate is coming apart from my card here, so I'm just putting it under my sellotape, which is a bit heavy, to help it dry without coming apart. But now I can carry on with the insert. So I also cut this shape, which I didn't show you in the design space bit of this video, but I just cut this random shape out because I figured that I wasn't going to be able to see my writing very well on the blue. So I've cut a shape out of white, and I'll just stick this to the inside right of the insert. And that's where I'll write my message. So I just push it down to get the glue nice and stuck. And that's my insert ready to go in the card. I'm just going to turn it upside down and put a row of double-sided tape down next to the crease. And this is how it will get stuck inside. I'm not going to stick it yet because my card's still drying, so I'll just put that to one side and have a look at the card. The acetate is nice and stuck now, so I can start sticking the other parts of the design. I'm going to start on the outside and put the bit with the ghost on the left hand side, and this is going to stick to the front of the card. This time I'm going to use double-sided tape and put a piece along all of the edges of the black bit of card. Make sure you don't go onto the acetate, because if you do, then you'll be able to see the tape from the other side. So if your tape is quite thick, then you might want to cut it in half so that it doesn't go onto the acetate. I'm going to go down all four sides of the card with my double-sided tape. Now I can take the ghost design and stick it to the front, and again be careful that you line it up exactly with the edges of the card so that everything is going to be lined up and you won't get any overlap. Push it down to make sure it's all nicely stuck on there, and then we can do the same thing on the inside. So you can see how that looks with the acetate. And when I open it up, at the minute it's a bit messy because you can see all the glue. To fix that, put some double-sided tape down all of the black edges on the inside, and then stick the other part of the picture design to the other side. So because we flipped this in Design Space, it's the perfect mirror image, which means we can line up the pictures and they will line up exactly, so you won't get any overlap when you look through. Again, push down to seal, and then that is the picture part of the card all finished. You can see when you open it, it means you've got the design on the front, and then it matches on the inside too. The last thing to do is to stick the insert inside. So take off the backing of the double-sided tape, make sure you've got it the right way around, and then open up the card and stick this to the inside right. Now when we were making the insert in Design Space earlier, you remember I said I made it a little bit small in my test cut, and you can see that here. So when you make yours, it should go to the edges of the black card a little bit better than mine does here. So this black border is a bit big on mine. Yours should be a little bit smaller. But here we go. There's the card. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. And subscribe to my YouTube channel for loads more Cricut and Design Space tutorials. Thank you for watching.